tram is bound for Nest. Do not exit until the final destination.
To me. You know it's supposed to be lucky.
I don't know what I'd do without you.
Are you kidding me? You were doing just fine without me until I came along and got you all sorts of trouble. I have something of yours.
I don't want it.
Really? Why not? So pretty.
It's from my mom. For my birthday last year. All I really wanted was for her to be home more.
I know it seems like your mom doesn't care, but... Hey. Sherry, come here. Hang in there, okay?
Now, arriving at Nest.
It's okay. I've got you. Come on. I'm getting you Matt, just hold on, Sherry. It's okay.
So, actors and actresses and everyone in between, they always have to lie about a role they're doing because they can't legally say something, or they just shouldn't say something. When the idea of having an Obi-Wan spinoff came into play for the Star Wars movies, people were like, yeah, that's totally cool. And then Ewan McGregor said, not happening, which was a lie. Everyone kept pressuring him. He's like, I'd love to be in one of those, but okay. I haven't been asked. Yeah, they kind of have to. They can't just outright say, well, yeah, it's happening, starts tomorrow, I don't fucking know. You know? So, obviously, with the,
antiviral agent, that's it. That's gotta be it. Hey, Sherry.
Oh, that was my neck.
Go.
So, with right the, here, okay? You know, upcoming Kenobi series on Disney Plus, whatever it's going to be called, the, Liam Neeson has said that he has not been called for, to reprise his role of Qui-Gon. And people are like, well, I guess it's not happening. And then Comic Book Cast 2 is like, what do you mean it's not happening? It's obviously happening. Remember, Ewan McGregor said the same thing a while ago. And yeah, Michael Rosenbaum, Lex Luthor on Smallville, said that there was not going to be any Smallville stuff during Crisis. That Tom Welling and Michael Rosenbaum had not been asked to participate in the event. That was a lie. After Tom Welling confirmed he was on there, people started pointing fingers at Michael Rosenbaum. And he was like, I won't be in the event because it just was inconvenient for me. But obviously I have to lie about that thing. or whatever, when I get the call. I'm not allowed to say anything. And yeah, he's right. I mean, it makes sense, man. You have to take what they say at face value, even if you don't think that they're, or even if you don't believe them. Like, if Qui-Gon says, or if Liam Neeson says no, then you have to be like, alright, no, and then later you can be like, he lied to us, but right now, that's just business, man. Makes sense to me. I don't know where people are getting confused on this subject. It's real simple to me, but I guess I don't fit everyone's idea. So makes sense. And I think the next video, guys, for you to look forward to is so I guess I'm done here. But I think the next video for you guys to look forward to is one on Knights of the Old Republic. I should have Knights of the Old Republic gameplay. If not, I'll have some sort of Star Wars gameplay. And, you know, in the background. And then we'll worry about the problems from there. But I want a Knights of the Old Republic movie. This High Republic stuff, that's cool too. Whatever. I don't like where it's going. Some of the character designs look really bad, and they're starting to look like what Marvel did for the Captain Marvel comics, where everyone is drawn in a gender-neutral way that looks fucking stupid, frankly. And I'm hoping they're not turning Star Wars into a new Warriors-type situation. The SJW characters. Dude, if they make a Marvel vs. Capcom 5, do not put those guys in there. I genuinely don't want a Marvel vs. Capcom game if it's going to have them in it. Alright, there, I said it. I genuinely mean that. If I see them anywhere in it, I'm not buying it. That's the facts. You can put Wolverine, Doctor Doom, Super Scroll back in there, still not buying it. Those characters are stupid and I'm making a statement. I think their book was canceled. But I don't know. I really hope their book was canceled. So whatever. But, yeah. I hope that's not what High Republic is turning into. Fuck. But Darth Revan, Darth Malak, Darth Malgus, Bastila, Karth, Mission, Vow, Zolibar? What was that? Those characters I fucking love. So, fucking, if High Republic's not gonna be garbage, put them in there if you insist you're not doing a fucking Old Republic situation. I believe High Republic is 2,000 years before Phantom Menace, whereas Old Republic is 4,000. But, I mean, if that shit's not canon... Look, dude, the Sith Troopers, their platoons are named after legendary Sith Lords. Revan, Malak, and Malgus have Sith Trooper platoons. So, you know.
damn it.
So, I want to start off this video with some bad news, but he's doing better now, so it's fine, ish, I guess. It's not fine, it's terrible, but, you know, he's doing better. My brother has been, hospitalized for Salmonella, so if there's less content coming out with me narrating, that's why. If there's more, if there are videos where I'm not talking about anything, that's why. But otherwise, everything should be fine. So far, that has not taken away from anything I'm doing. But I am a little worried about him, obviously. Or quite a bit worried about him. So, now that we got that out of the way, here's something that bugs me in online video games. I'm playing Star Wars Battlefront 2. Call of Duty, Doom Eternal, Doom 2016 even, or really anything, I suppose. Like, have you, you know, like, really any multiplayer game, I just can't think of a lot of them. You're doing your thing. You invite your friend because they want to play with you, and you're like, oh, cool, wouldn't it be awesome if we fought each other? And instead, no. You go online, you invite your friend, and it's mandatory that they be on your team. Sorry, but in Battlefront 2, when I'm playing with my brother, I should say earlier, my little brother, is, he's the one who's hospitalized. The brother who actually plays video games is, he's fine. When I'm playing with my middle brother, I invite him to Battlefront 2. I'm like, alright, wouldn't it be cool if I was Anakin and you were fucking Vader or something like that? You know, we're playing, he's not that into Star Wars, but, you know, so I want to fight you. And we're just both stuck on the same team. Playing on the same team is cool, no doubt. But I want to fight against my friend. I want to learn who's better. I mean, you know, I almost certainly get less score than he does. But I'm fairly confident that I could beat him. Like, I have gotten more score than him in the past, but there have been some times where I'm like, whoa, you were able to do that? I can't even do that. And, you know, so, and then Doom Eternal, if you're playing multiplayer, you have to, and you invite a friend, he has to be a demon, and you have to be a demon. What if I want to fight my friend, and he's a demon, and I'm a slayer? That would be cool, but that's just not possible. So, yo, Doom 3, or maybe even Doom Eternal, since it's still being updated, and, or I guess it wouldn't be Doom 3, it would be whatever the sequel to Doom Eternal is. And then Battlefront 3, let me do that. What if, and my brother does not like space combat in Battlefront, which is unfortunate, but what if I'm over here trying to blow up the Death Star, and my friend has to stop me? That would be an awesome rivalry that we can't have. I guess it's to prevent cheating, but it's dumb. Yeah, it's like, hey, Michael, my friend is this way. Come on. Or, like, no, it would be, hey, Michael, Darth Vader is over here. Or, hey, Chance, Luke Skywalker's over here, come kill him. You know, that kind of shit. But at the same time, I don't care. I want to fight my friend. In fact, the same thing could be done anyways in Battlefront with that logic, because you could just get, like, Princess Leia, I think. And, or no, Boba Fett. And then, scout out other characters and stuff when you get to a vantage point, and then tell your friend over the comms if they're on your team as well. So it's the same thing, just to a lesser extent. So it's dumb that I can't fight my friends. I want to, but I can't. And just imagine in Dragon Ball FighterZ online multiplayer matches, your friend had to be part of your party. So you select two characters and he selects one, and then you can't fight each other, you have to be on the same team. Wouldn't that be annoying? What if you have this awesome X-Men Days of Future Past game, and you want your friend to control Sentinel, and you want to be Wolverine, but now suddenly it's just Wolverine and Cyclops versus a bunch of Sentinels that are controlled by the AI. Like, come on, man. Goku explained Earth's predicament and asked the new Grand Elder Mori if he knew any... I fucking hate that shit. I understand in some games why it would be like that. Marvel Ultimate Alliance, for instance. That's kind of... You don't play as the bad guys. Well, you can. But you're not going to be able to control the drones or play as the boss. Marvel's Avengers. Well, fuck yeah, you're not gonna be able to play as MODOK or play as fucking Super Skrull or something like that. And then, Batman Gotham Knights. I'm not expecting you to be able to play as Harley Quinn, Joker, Two-Face, or Catwoman. I'm expecting the four characters that they've shown off to be the only four characters. Aside from Batman, he's gonna be the fifth character, I mark my words. I've probably talked about this before, but that's what's gonna happen. Or in Suicide Squad, you're not gonna be playing as Batman or Superman. You're gonna be playing as the Suicide Squad. So in those kind of games that are co-op, that's totally fine. In Star Wars Battlefront, where you can play as Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader, you should be able to fight one another. In Doom Eternal, where you can play as demons or slayers, you should be able to fight each other. That's just how that is. Aight, fool?
I mean, I'd have to make the proper adjustments. But if you did that, it would count as two wishes. Oh? Is that all?
Fine by me. Let's do it.
All right, I'll begin right away. The Dragon Ball should be restored now.
Wait, what? Already?
Incredible. Looks like this little guy has some serious power.
All right, I'll round up all the Dragon Balls then. Gohan, consider your training complete. Kick back with Dende until the Cell games start.
Huh? But...
Hey, don't worry. It'll be fine. Later. Well, time to get looking.
Before we get into this video, I want to explain why I should be allowed to slap the shit out of some of our customers. Like, I probably shouldn't say that, but the one I'm talking about in particular, I mean, aside from one who was yelling at me about how all the tables were dirty, but, like, none of the tables were dirty, my job is cleaning them, and I cleaned them for hours, and I have literal receipts proving it. I spent an hour and a half overtime cleaning those tables. So, do not yell at me about how the tables are dirty. However, the one that really pissed me off, she was offended because I was white, and she kept yammering about how I should be fired and how someone of color should be, you know, in my position. When I was cleaning out the tables, she said, seriously, the busboy is white. And I was like, the fuck? I never confronted her about it. But she sat on the table and she was like, thank you for cleaning the table. And I was like, mm-hmm. And it's like, it's too bad you're white. And I was like, what the fuck is wrong with this chick? And one of the other customers stood up and said, you know, you really shouldn't talk to someone like that. It seems like you're kind of a racist. Or she's like, I agree other job opportunities should be offered to people of color and whatever, but it seems like you're kind of racist. And she was like, you can't be racist to a white guy. I was like, bitch, I'm gonna slap you. She kind of got under my skin. Not because, you know, oh, fucking racial comment. I don't care if you call me a... I've said it before. I'm not gonna say it here, because I guess this is already a charged video for me. But... You know what, I don't want to make this my Star Wars video. I think I'm gonna attach that to something else. This will just be a vlog video, I guess, that gets put up every now and then. So how's your day? I was like, you're offended because I'm white? Also, I'm not, you know, trying to make this a race thing. I'm just gonna stop where I was going with that. So this is, like, from the future. Where I was going with that was not good, so we're not going there. But anyways, her name was Karen, with a C, and, I mean, that last part is kind of a joke. I don't know if it had a C or anything. I never saw her name written up, but her friends were calling her Karen, and one of them actually said, way to go, Karen, you stood up to the oppressor. To which I was like, bitch. Bitch? So, yeah, that was something. Yeah. One of the elusive, obviously racist Karens. That's right, I found one of them. That was also from the future. I had to cut myself off again because I said something that I didn't want to say. So, one of the elusive, obviously racist Karens. Some of them are secretly racist, but she was obviously racist. So yeah, some customers need a good slapping, and that has just been confirmed. But yeah, she was like, when she started talking to me about it, as if I didn't have, like, you know, any cognitive thinking. I don't know what she expected me to. So yeah, what was I saying? I guess the moral of the story, I can't remember what I was saying. So the moral of the story is, some people just shouldn't exist. Like, again, I'm not offended, I'm just kind of pissed off. I felt like she was stupid, and that's really where I have a problem. I don't care if someone, you know, I genuinely don't care if someone hurled slurs at me. I just want it to be said. She really pissed me off because I had to deal with a lot of her kind today. A lot of, oh, you know, people of color, this, you fucking suck that. And then one person just kept telling me that all the tables were dirty, and if I didn't clean them, she was gonna report me to the manager. Bitch, what the fuck do you think you're doing? That last lady in particular actually had a separate customer come by and say, I'm sorry, you have to deal with that on a daily basis. And I was like, oh, today doesn't suck so bad because someone actually is nice. Yeah, so. See, I gotta get back to laundry and then I'm doing my Star Wars video. Yeah. Later.
Get too close to the hostages. We don't want to draw any more of those alien things down there.
Trip. These things are still coming.
I got a nuke coming in. It's going to blow in less than a minute. And I know just where to put it.
Hawkeye.
I got it.
So, this is like the only time I'll say anything about Twitter being batshit, because everyone already knows this. Actually, I take that back. This isn't going to be the only time. But basically, James Arnold Taylor, who voices Obi-Wan in basically anything that does not have Ewan McGregor in it, he's being accused of being racist and just leftist, I think. I'm not good with politics. Just, you know, accusing of having different beliefs than everyone else and being a racist. And then I'm seeing misinformation going about as people are saying that Mark Hamill is also supporting these other people in accusing him. Yellow Flash, I think it was, said that Mark Hamill had shamed him, which just isn't true, because I found he's doing the same thing everyone else is doing, supposedly. Because, now, I could have misheard this, I'm not 100% on it, but I'm hearing people saying, oh, well, Mark Hamill's the bad guy, too. He is just, you know, he's slamming another Star Wars actor. Da-da-da-da-da. When that's not what's happening at all. He posted some stupid stuff and he echoed some stupid stuff on Parler, which is basically like Twitter, basically. And echoing is basically retweeting. Diva, what are you doing? So, you know. And yeah, he, something about, like, the coronavirus being made in a lab. And, I mean, I don't know if he believes that. Personally, I do. I'm not, like, I don't have any evidence, so I'm not out there spreading the fucking word. Because I don't make baseless accusations. But that's personally what I believe, is I think that it just has to be. However, I'm not selling, like, fight my battles for me, peasant. You know, because I don't know. I could be proven wrong tomorrow and be like, well, fuck, I guess not. There's no evidence regarding this. It's just, well, there is evidence, but I don't have a thorough understanding of said evidence. And I'm not fucking in China trying to figure out that shit. So, I don't know. I'm not spreading the word. I'm not trying to, I guess I'm spreading the word now, but that's not what I'm intending to do. The point of this is people are fucking crazy. He retweeted something, and then something else, and one of them was about the NFL, and then Yellow Flash, I know this for a fact, he's like, oh, people are offended by all this shit, and he's like, I'm not watching the NFL anymore because I disagree with their politics. It's like, what the fuck? You're doing the same thing they're doing. That one I know for a fact I have right. I'm not spreading any false information. That's presented to me right in front of me. So, what he calls them is Twitter Puritans and Reset Era folk. Now, the Reset Era thing is because that's actually a thing. But, you know, he gets so fucking annoying with this Twitter Puritans. He's like, oh, you disagree with the politics. You can't enjoy anything else. Haha. And then he's like, I disagree with the NFL's politics. It's like, motherfucker, it's football. Watch the damn football or don't. I'm not into sports, period. It's never been my thing. Look at my channel. Does that seem like I've ever been slightly interested in sports? Admittedly, I'd rather be doing the sports I might be interested in, but I'm not in any shape to be doing sports, so I don't. Anyways, moral of the story. These accusations that are going nuts, by the time this video gets put out, it'll be too late, but they want him fired from Ratchet & Clank. I don't know what that is. It's a Sony game, apparently. But basically,
he's doing a role in that game. People want him fired because of his beliefs. Like, give the man a break. I don't understand why this is any of your concern. I'm gonna have to fucking beat a dog. That was a joke, by the way. But it's 10 o'clock at night and she insists to be barking for a treat, so just went and got a water bottle and sprayed her. Granny just would rather yell at Jess than actually spray her. Which is stupid, because she's always talking about, oh, Jess should be wearing this collar. The collar isn't a zap collar, it shoots water at her. So why can't they just have a spray bottle, you motherfucker? Anyways, point of the story. These accusations against him are stupid. I don't care if he's a literal Nazi. He has not been proven to be such, and has not done anything that would indicate such. If he is, well then fuck, man. He's worse than Hitler. I don't care. Fuck him. But he's just a dude who's doing things. Yeah, maybe he should have not done anything that would be slightly controversial, because idiots are getting offended over everything now. Dude, the fucking sky will turn green one day, and people will be throwing a fucking conniption fit. Like, I want the sky fucking blue. Yeah, well, motherfucker, it's green. Deal with it. We'll be chasing the tails like fucking crazy. So, yeah. Basically, he should just stand his ground, if I were him. Something knocked on my door and there's nothing there, so that's really spooky. If it were me, I would just say, if you don't like me, fine, deal with it. But I've done nothing wrong, and I'm not going to apologize for anything. I'm not backing down. I've done nothing wrong. Kiss my ass. That's what I would say, you know, genuinely. Maybe that's the wrong move, but that would genuinely... I mean, I think my reaction would more like be suck my dick, but kiss my ass is just more... It can be taken more seriously, let's just say. Yeah, this dude's done nothing wrong. When I was watching this video, I was getting... I think I just misheard what the dude was saying, because he interrupts himself several times just to say the term Twitter Puritans. It's really fucking annoying. It's like his catchphrase or something. But anyways, when I was getting that information, he would be like, oh, look, it's a... Oh, wait, Twitter Puritans. Obi-Wan, Twitter Puritan. Ben Solo, Twitter Puritan. Every other word is Twitter Puritan. So it's hard to understand what the fuck this guy's going on about. But basically, from what I've gathered, people just made up some shit about it, and now it's actually causing problems. Oh, no. Now, again, if I were him, I would say, fact check your fucking sources and kiss my ass. And that'd be the end of it. Of course, I don't know if he's allowed to say that in order to keep a job. He probably has to, like, fucking be very careful about what he says. But, dude, everyone always finds something to get offended about. If you look at... This is actually a perfect opportunity to talk about, the other cancel culture cases recently. So, first thing to talk about. James Gunn was canceled over some tweets, and Disney fired him from Guardians 3 and immediately rehired him. But by that point, WB had already swooped in and was like, alright, you're doing Suicide Squad. I do not know what Disney's logic was. If it were me, I'd have held on to him. I'm like, alright, so what? He said something on Twitter that pissed people off. I don't know what he said, and it could have genuinely been bad, but your career shouldn't be taken away from you because of something you said. I mean, or even freaking something you retweeted. I think I've retweeted a few things and not even realized it. Genuinely, On Twitter, it's you literally just hit a button and there's no "are you sure" or "all right, successfully." It's literally you just do it. I don't even talk to anyone on Twitter. I just use it to look at things, and I've retweeted it. So, I mean, it happens. I don't know about this parlor thing. I don't give a fuck. But, you know, it just fucking happens, all right? You click the wrong button. You think you've liked the post instead you've retweeted it. Oh, well, on Twitter it does now give you a thing. It's like retweet with comment or retweet with... Just retweet. But it didn't always do that. And, again, I don't know how Parler is set up. It... Moral of the story, it doesn't fucking matter. Anyways, James Gunn, he posted something, and it was apparently really bad. So he deleted it, and he apologized. But then someone used some sort of Twitter archive to find it. And then they got offended about it. And then Disney fired him. And then WB hired him. And then Disney's like, "You're back." And everything's fine with him. Nothing substantial. Aside from Guardians being pushed back a few years. But then... the other thing is... Ooh. Spicy. The other one was, Justin Hartley. That's not Justin Hartley. That's Green Arrow from Smallville. Who am I thinking of? Hartley Sawyer. Ralph Dibny from The Flash. He was fired because of some tweets that were misogynistic and racist. And again, your career shouldn't be just fucking obliterated because you said something wrong. I mean, come on. Who hasn't said something mildly racist or mildly misogynistic? It just happens. Alright, I will fess up. I have done that, alright? It just happens, whether accidental or intentional. Mine has never been intentional, but I've said it. And sure, he said it intentionally. But who gives a fuck? It's words. And at the end of the day, words aren't killing anyone. That's the way I see it. And he's apologized numerous times, but this time, they just uncovered really bad things. And got offended by it. Because I guess he left it open. But see, someone went out of their way to go into his Twitter and find shit from 45,000 fucking years ago to get offended by. To get him out of a job. Personally, I think someone should track down that person and get in contact their employers to unemploy them. See, because that's what should happen. You know, you're ruining someone's life and livelihood. Bastard's lucky he's not being executed. But fucking, anyways, the next, case is... Who else was being canceled? Over something stupid. What was it? Jenna Marbles or something like that? I can't remember who it was. Justine or Jenna Marbles. One of them. I always get the two mixed up. I don't remember what her deal was. And so I have no room to talk about it. But, you know, the names just keep coming up. And it's over menial things. And then the people who go out of their way to cancel them don't really care. They just want to get everyone riled up. And then they feel like they've done something good for society when really they're just a cancerous twat that wants attention for 5 minutes, and in doing so ruins other people's lives. They should be paid no attention. And honestly, I can only wish the worst for them. It's just... I mean, dude. I have social anxiety as it is. You guys know this. I could say the wrong thing when I go to work tomorrow. And that's it. That is fucking terrifying. Alright? when I went to therapy over my social anxiety, the therapist, she's like, well, it's not like you're just going to say the wrong thing and suddenly everybody hates you. That's unrealistic. And I'm like, really? Just fucking look around. That happens all the time. Now, personally, the reason I was there had nothing to do with because, oh, look what I found on the internet, people getting offended and whatever. I don't give a fuck about someone else's opinion. I don't give a fuck about the other people getting pissed off. I'm just trying to make sure it doesn't ruin anyone's life. But personally, I don't care what someone says to me. I don't care what someone thinks about me. I really don't give a fuck. It's the people that I know who I don't want to lose a relationship with. I had someone like a while ago and I said the wrong thing and that door was closed permanently. There was no opening that door back up. And, then it happened again. And then again. And I just had some toxic people in my life, honestly. One of said toxic people turned out to be, a few months ago he killed a guy, so that, he's in juvenile detention or something like that now. So, I mean, yeah, real toxic people. There was nothing, that piece of shit is, yeah, none of that was on me, and I know that now. The only people who get genuinely riled up and offended by something one person can say, what I've learned is in, you know, people you know personally, not some random person on the internet, if they get pissed off with you and they close that door off permanently, that door is just, locked forever.
So hot, I can barely breathe.
That's not all. This place is as big as the earth itself.
They never really cared about you to begin with.
Out there and you're a goner.
If you lose someone over something like that, they never cared. They pretended to, or they thought they did.
So
but if they're willing to close the door off like that,
in here?
They should have meant nothing
all,
to you, and
like we're here on vacation.
You must have meant
first
very little to
first,
them.
We're gonna make you
otherwise, they
Super
wouldn't
Saiyan.
Have done that.
A Super Saiyan?
But
I
guess in the case
of
my
take.
First locked door,
do.
That was my
Don't
fault.
Forget that you got Saiyan blood.
That's a mistake I haven't repeated
body.
Since, and
all that said, any
the other
real
stuff,
type of training we need to do isn't gonna happen
you know,
until you're a
the other stuff
Saiyan.
I said that locked doors, that
Aren't
was them. That had nothing to do with me.
And
I take responsibility for my actions.
Well, yeah,
but when you make
first.
A little joke and then someone,
don't get me wrong.
You know,
I'm planning on going
retaliates physically,
when the time
which is
right.
what happened.
I've got plans for you too. I want
that
you to
person,
get even stronger than that. I know
you shouldn't concern
it.
Yourself with them.
What?
Now as for what's happening with the
stronger
people on the internet, they can go fuck themselves,
yep.
honestly.
If anyone can do that,
I'm hoping to see Hartley Sawyer
you.
Come back on The Flash. It's not
Man.
Too late, I don't think.
I hope I can.
I think really everyone involved
Relax.
In the situation
time,
should be
so
ashamed of
rush.
Themselves. People change
we'll
and it was
nice
words from that
first.
Were spoken years ago.
Now that's enough talking. Let's get warmed up.
I mean, the fact that Grant Gustin and, you know, the rest of the CW were just like, or the rest of the show, were just like, yeah, fuck you. That's despicable.
Don't go easy on me, okay?
Ironically, that goes against his whole reason for being on the show, which was people change. The whole story with Barry Allen and Ralph Dibny. You guys remember how that started in season 4? From season 7? They're just like, yeah, you're off the show now. So that's, you know. But, these people on the internet canceling other people have an inflated self of importance, sense of importance, of fuck, have a highly inflated sense of self-importance. And they feel like, well, yeah, by ruining this guy's life completely and totally, I've done something right in the world. I've earned my place here on this planet, making other people miserable. So, yeah. Like, I don't care. Honestly, now, personally, I'm gonna get controversial here real quick. I genuinely don't care if someone says the N-word. I don't care if someone... Diva, why are you... You're asleep. Why are you breathing like that? I don't care if someone says the N-word. I don't care if someone just is just a complete racist. If you're a complete racist, you're a piece of shit. I don't care if someone says something completely racist. I don't know. Like, if you're talking to your friend, you know, it's, you're engaging in conversation, you're just being friendly, you're just being you're joking around. Who gives a fuck? Personally, I don't care if anyone calls me a cracker, but there's a double standard there and I will retaliate. Not physically, I mean, you know, by saying other words. But... So I don't care if someone calls me that. And especially if it's in a joking manner. I have several friends that call me that. Granted, two of the four are white, but I don't give a shit. It's friendly banter. It's not used in a demeaning way. It's just a joke.
It is. But your now, techniques and movements are pretty great. I'm betting you've got Piccolo to thank for all that. Guess that means we can move straight on to Super Saiyan training. What do you say?
So, there's really nothing to be offended about. One of the problems in this world is that everyone gets so pissed off about every little thing. And when you're a celebrity,
all you're doing is raising like, your energy. That's not enough.
Hartley Sawyer,
need to get angry to become a Super Saiyan.
James Gunn,
get angry.
Anyone, you're an easy target. You say something, someone doesn't like that, they'll fucking cancel you because they've got nothing else to do that day. Personally, I think nothing that anyone gets offended by, unless it's fucking illegal. You know what? Have you guys watched King of Kings, I think is what it was? No. Twin Kings or something like that? It was on Disney, and one of the guys got pulled off the show because he was like a drunk driver, or he was like driving drunk or something, so he was in like jail for a lot of its filming. The show is garbage, I thought so then, but I was always wondering, you know, like, what happened to that guy? Why did he just get replaced with this guy? Well, because he was driving drunk because he was a fucking idiot. That's something to truly get offended by, because well, now he's put other people's lives in danger.
I'm coming too.
But no one cared. No one fucking cared. And then the guy that they replaced him with robbed banks. I can't remember if it was around the U.S., or around the world. But he started that spree, and he's been dubbed the new... Or him and his wife or something have been dubbed the new Bonnie and Clyde. And no one fucking cares. But suddenly, someone says something on the internet, and it's a problem. An international, or at the very least, you know, all over the country, bank robber... and a drunk driver... aren't getting canceled. But, oh, you said something about babies and you probably accidentally said the N-word at one point in your life. That was probably, like, your first word when you were, like, 2 years old. Because you heard it off of a movie and so you just started repeating it. Now you're being fucking canceled. For no good reason. Are you fucking serious? You're joking, right? No one fucking cares. No one fucking cares. Here, I'll look up the guys right now. Alright, guys, I got pulled up right now, and I'm not trying to say, like, go ahead and cancel fucking everybody, but, the first one, Mitchell Musso, I guess. King Brady, let's see what he's got. That can't be right. Yes, being charged with DUI. And then if we go to Adam Hicks. Pretty sure Adam Paul Nielsen Hicks is an American. That's not it. This is the guy, right? Let's see, let's just scroll down. What happened to Adam Hicks? Update, Adam Hicks appeared in court on Wednesday, where he pled not guilty to 3 felony counts of attempted second-degree robbery and 2 felony counts of second-degree robbery. What? Oh. And robbery, and report the former actor's bail was set at... But you don't hear people fucking talking about this. It's just because they got offended by someone saying something on the internet that they disagreed with or they found offensive. If I jokingly said, kill all of the puppies. Well, fuck. I'm worse than Adam Hicks, apparently. Now, let me see how this actually happened. Because that was an old article from 2018. Let me look him up again. Adam Hicks, there we go. What's the deal? Did he get off guilty? Or what was he determined? What happened to Adam Hicks? But will remain in custody. Da, 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 da. I thought it was bank robbery. Back in January, the 2015-year-old Disney actor. Lemonade Mouth. I don't know what that is. I guess, whatever, that's irrelevant. Adam's attorney notified the judge that ongoing medical and mental health issue, da, 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 rather than rehabbing, developed. Diva, you are so fucking loud when you're sleeping. Do you need to be rolled over? Don't look at me like that. Why are you doing that? Are you okay? Based on the outcome of his case, we'll resume either with defense or further medical evaluation. So is he playing the insanity plea? Don't you love when they do that? I can't... Okay, the article's fucked and it's fucking my phone right now. In 2020, alright, this one's new. Every Gen Z Disney kid remembers 2011 Lemonade Mouth. Never fucking heard of it. Drama has been deemed... Dream? What the fuck? Ex-Disney star was arrested for armed robbery alongside a woman named Danny Timbero in Burbank, California. Oh wait, maybe that's where I got the bank thing from, is Burbank. Alleged robberies. So... nothing's happened yet? A few months prior to the alleged robberies, according to TMZ, authorities were called when the actor accidentally shot himself in the leg. That's fucking hardcore. And a few months later, he was later arrested for domestic violence against his... oh, fuck. So that one's confirmed, though. And he's not being canceled. Who's original scene? In terms of smaller productions, I don't give a fuck what he's working on, what happened to him. Clearly, Adam's gone through quite a business without someone on the big and small screens. More from... what? It doesn't say. So this could be allegedly, but the first part is at least confirmed. And no one's canceling this motherfucker. But James Gunn says something on the internet that pisses off two guys. Zeke and Luther was another one, I guess. That he was on, but... again, I don't really give a fuck what he was on. The point of the story is... people treat words as if they're the end of the world. When really, you can just get your pussy self over it. But then... dude robs people. And... beats his... whatever. I mean, beating your meat is fine, man, but you're not beating your meat, you're beating your wife. So, that's where we take issue, guys. Are you fucking serious? I'm not trying to get him canceled, although he deserves it, let's be honest. But, Jesus, Get your priorities straight. Moral of the story, James Arnold Taylor. Fucking Jenna Marbles, I hope that's the right one. James Gunn and hopefully Hartley Sawyer will pull through just fine. They've done nothing wrong, in my opinion. I mean, literally, all four of them could just be fucking Nazis. They haven't been proven of that. They just said something you disagreed with, and now suddenly they're fucking Hitler. But no one fucking cares when Disney puts something in the water and someone goes on a robbery or on a robbing spree. Them priorities be whack, dog.
So yeah. Shut the fuck up. Thank you. So, I figured out what happened. Mark Hamill did slam Parler, which again, I have no idea what the fuck that is, never heard of it. But he did say that the accusations against James Arnold Taylor are untrue. Honestly, yeah, slamming Parler, he does need to get his priorities straightened out a bit. But I'm guilty of the same kind of thing, so fucking kill us both, I guess. I've been like, yeah, Twitter fuck, yeah, like, James Gunn, I said something along the lines to a friend. I was like, James Gunn's been fired from Disney. Fuck Disney and fuck Twitter, rather than being like, yeah, well, you know, maybe he should, maybe, what he's, you know, I should have just said like, well, fucking James Gunn didn't do anything wrong, whereas I was just like, fuck Twitter, fuck Disney. Yeah, so, whatever. I think, logically, Parler, Disney, Twitter, they should all be left out of the equation. But Mark Hamill's not the bad guy just because his priorities were just a little whack for a split second. I mean, my priorities have been whacker at times. Like, my priorities have almost fucking resulted in my death, honestly. So, let's be honest, priorities can be a bit of a problem. Maybe I'll elaborate on that in the future, but at the moment, let's just say that I was almost killed by my own priorities. So, I can't really blame anyone else for having faulty priorities. Which, anyone who's in the right for having faulty priorities. This whole video was about people's priorities, so I'm faulting people on their priorities, even though my priorities have been off at times. But at the same time, that's not the whole point. That's like the whole point of the video, but that's not the whole point of the video. You guys get what I'm saying? I'm gonna stop talking now before I incriminate myself. Dude, if I'm ever framed for any crime whatsoever, and it looks like they have a decent bit of evidence on me, I'm just gonna lawyer up because I am the kind of guy who would just automatically incriminate myself. I don't know what it is that I would do, but I would incriminate myself. They'd be like, hey, did you rob this Walmart? I'd be like, I'd be like, nope, never heard of Walmart before. Walmart. That would be me, honestly. I'd just be in the cops. So I'd just lawyer up. I'd be like, give me an attorney and I'll cooperate 100%. I mean, if they're just like, hey, do you know this man? I'll be like, oh yeah, fuck, that's my bro, man. He lives that way. You know. But when I'm put in this hot seat, I'd be like, fuck, I don't know what you're talking about. Nah, but realistically, yeah, alright. Let's just get priorities straight, people. Bye. dudes, by this part, by this time, Trump has basically lost. But it's still possible. However, he's suing for a recount. He's suing three, you know, states for basically trying to get a recount on votes, which I can kind of agree with. I think for CNN to report shit like, well, look at how his son dresses, it's, how does that reflect on Trump? Like, that's an actual thing they actually did. Yet no one wants to talk about the fact that Biden is probably the most racist guy there is. People claim that the people who Trump associates with are problematic. Biden's best friend / mentor guy is part of the KKK. Someone called him a grand wizard at the KKK. But it's incredibly dumb. And the fact that this is what's happening here is incredibly stupid. And then you have CNN reporting that he is, that this was totally fair with no interference whatsoever, is incredibly stupid. And then the media goes out and cuts him off during his speech, which, you know what, it seems accurate, but the media themselves can just debate, and instead they're just muting him. They basically muted him. That's fucked. I mean, he could be saying, shit, I've discovered the cure for cancer, and then they're just gonna be like, sorry, we have to cut him off because he's spewing incorrect facts. But dude, here in my hometown, I've already seen enough of this. Someone wrote, or someone plastered stickers, or a poster or something on a trash can, and it said ballot box. Obviously, that's not gonna be the most convincing thing, but I know for a fact I got one person, because I watched it. And then you have the fact that elsewhere someone blew up a mailbox because someone saw the votes being put in it for a mail-in ballot. And then when I was going to vote, the machine said, or the machine errored, and my machine wouldn't even let me vote for certain candidates. But mine, or someone else's machine actually had some sort of error. I don't know what that was all about, and they threw it out. So, I mean, it's fucked. You also have, there was something else that people were doing that was really, you know, but yeah, someone put C4 or something on the mailbox and it blew up. Then someone, you know, ballot box the trash can, and then there was, I keep dropping this fucking pin. And then someone, you know, there was a few things, and the fact that they're saying totally fair environment, nothing's rigged, everything happened as it should. No. Also, the electoral college is bullshit. Think about this. You have four dwarves. You have four tall people. And you have two regular guys. And let's say one regular guy and four dwarves voted Biden. Well, one regular guy and four tall people vote Trump. The smaller people have more votes. their vote counts more. That's the Electoral College, as I understand it at this moment. I have not looked into it, but I'm going to after this video. So don't take that with a grain of salt, please. But that is how I understand it at this moment. I don't have time. I'm currently busy. But yeah, that's that. So I'll correct myself either in the video or in another video. But that's... And please, I encourage you guys to look it up. That's how this happens, okay? That is... The small people have more vote. I don't understand it. It should just be whoever has the most total votes. The electoral votes shouldn't... That should not be a thing. So, of course, the situation is as it is. However, the, dude, it's like 8 o'clock right now, and the trash people still have not gotten here. It's 8 p.m., by the way. So that's impressive. Anyways, fuck this idiot clean. So, I understand, where Trump's coming from, honestly. I do think he should win, because so far he's done great. Last year, I'm pretty sure, the worst thing CNN had on him was, look at how his son dresses. Isn't that disgraceful? How does this reflect on Trump himself? And then the best thing they had, or that other people had on him, was... he's greatly improved laws for transgender people and, whatever people. And then, and people of color, that was what it was, I forgot that term. And then, you have Biden, who said shit like, who currently, this pin, I keep dropping it, it's my fucking fault, but it's bothering me. Here we go. So, Biden, and this is a quote, said, if you don't vote for me, you're not black. What the fuck is wrong with this guy? And then he said, he had the gall to say, marriage should be between a man and a woman. Whereas, all the way back in the 80s, Trump was on the record for saying, I'm not into it. But if a man wants to marry another man, that's fine by me. You guys say that Biden is for all these things that Biden is not for. And then you ignore everyone else. And then you say Trump is against all of these things that he's openly supporting. None of it makes any fucking sense. You say you want to vote Biden for such and such when that's what Trump's trying to do. Say you're not voting Trump because of such and such when that's what Biden is currently doing. Look into what the fuck... What, are you voting last minute or are you voting because you are a Democrat or a Republican? Or what are you voting, like, all one side? When I went and voted, I'm a Republican, but for... a few of the positions, I went Democrat because, well, I know what he's for and I know what he's doing. And that's totally cool if he's as honest as he is about that. He was like Justice of the Peace or something. And so I didn't go all Republican just because, well, I'm a Republican, I guess. Because I don't fall in line with either side. I did mostly vote Republican, but I don't fall one way or the other. It's, all right, what do I believe in? Who is as close to that as possible? When it seems like people are just like, left, right, Republican, Democrat, fucking, you're a Nazi, you're a white supremacist because Twitter said so. You're a liberal because Twitter said so. Have you seen what's happening with Chris Pratt? He didn't support Biden. or he didn't openly support Biden, and now people have a problem with it. Does that tell you something? That maybe Biden's supporters are... Maybe the people who are blindly following Biden have no fucking idea what they're doing? I hate to be the one who's like, well, I'm against this, I'm against that, you suck, you don't, you know? But very clearly, some of them actually fucking suck. Someone called Chris Pratt a white supremacist with no basis, except he went to a church which did something at some point. How would you like it if I fucking went up to fucking Shigeru Miyamoto and was like, you're a fucking Nazi because you said something that I didn't like about one of your characters that you created. Like, what the fuck? That doesn't prove anything. Look, man. So he attends a church that did something a while ago. The way I see it is I like Smallville, even though Allison Mack is a terrible person. I can still enjoy Smallville, although I'm kind of reminded every now and then, like, oh yeah, she's not that great a person. So he can fucking attend a church. Maybe it has new man. I don't fucking know. That's not the point of this video anyways. That's just, you know, an abridged version of another video I did. The point of this video is... people have no idea what the fuck they're doing. Maybe you know what you're doing. Maybe someone else knows what they're doing. Maybe half the people, maybe the majority of the people know what they're doing. Some people clearly don't. Why do we have the media being political? The media should remain apolitical. Or whatever the fucking term is. They should remain neutral. Be like, oh, well, Trump's doing this, but I think that Biden is doing this, and that's great, too. Or that's great as well. You can influence in subtle ways, I guess, but you can't just be bashing Trump every single second and then promoting Biden another when you're getting your shit mixed up. And when, seriously, the only fucking thing you have to say is Trump's kid is wearing offensive clothing... when that's the only thing you have to say, don't fucking say it. I mean, if you want to throw that on after you say, oh, well, fucking Trump just killed a man, then fine, that's inappropriately timed too, but that's appropriate. You can't just make a fucking article about fucking... can't just make something about someone wearing a different shirt or wearing something offensive. You know there are people who boycotted Star Wars because... I mean, I don't like this lady either, but I can't remember. Kathleen Kennedy, I think it is? Someone boycotted Star Wars because she was wearing a shirt that said the Force is female. That's fucking fine. I don't give a damn. But it seems like the same logic goes into CNN sometimes. I'm singling out CNN, but I don't think I actually mean CNN. I think it's a... I don't know who posted what, alright? I'll be honest. But you can look it up. It's easy. In fact, I'll do it right now. Alright, I can't find it. I encourage you guys to, though, because, right now, everything's flooded with poll results. I went on, like, 9 pages and didn't find anything. 9 different pages, and, like, 2 different... 3 different search terms. And I just found shit about the poll. One of the things that I searched didn't even have fucking Trump in the... well, it did have Trump. But it had his kid's name in it. And it just started talking about the poll again. So, whatever. So yeah, I encourage you guys to make your own decisions. I'm not trying to influence you one way or the other. I'm just reporting facts and sort of arguing with the news. Someone can debunk this. I don't give a fuck. Honestly? Alright guys, I gotta go. Make up your own minds, make up your own opinion, do some research, and come on. And fuck it, debunk me. I want a debate. I like having, you know, a conversation with people, as long as it can be rational, as long as no one's yelling, no one's throwing a fit, everyone acts like in a fucking adult. Oh shit. Alright, new problem. I gotta go. Later.
Thank you.